I was wondering the other day when out cycling why some of the signs say the modern 14%, the percentage gradient, and others still say 1 in 2 or 1 in 4 or whatever. It's so confusing. Why don't they all say percent? I know the 1 in 2 was the old way of doing it. And there are more hedge cuttings. You can't see any hedge. It looks like it's been trimmed. Yeah, this brings us down to Fountains Hall and the little cottages here that you can rent. Holiday cottages. On the river. Very soon we'll be climbing. This is the lower car park. Do this first bit in first queue. It was Abbey boundary walls there. Ancient. Over there, you probably can't see it, but you can see the tower of the Fountains Abbey Church. Bit of a ease off before we go up again. am I going to move up gears? That first bit was quite steep, so I did it in first gear. Go up to second. Yeah, did that bit in second gear. Bit of ease off again. Gradual climb. Camp has been there for years, decades. Right, another bit of a climb around the corner, on the bend. Only a little one. We have, of course, done this bit all the other way round, right from Malkington past here through the Studley Royal Deer Park and Ripon. I think that's the top of that climb. A bit of downhill coming up before we start the Brimham Rocks ascent. We've often come out there from Markington, haven't we, and gone there to Fountains Abbey, but not today. It's a lovely breeze now. a climb coming up. I know when I get to those railings on the right that the climb is coming up. Not ancient. But it's not that ancient, it says 1818. 1685. Make it in mind. Probably an extension. Anyway, here is the steep climb. Short, sharp. And we've not got to the Brimham Rocks climb yet. We go right here. There's Brimham Rocks 5, but the actual climb is probably about 4 miles. Take it nice and easy before the climb, nice and easy. Probably have a drink too. I think the gradual climb is starting here. Left here. Going to try not to go down to first gear, I'm in second gear. Bike coach said always, well for this particular ride, ride in a gear that feels slightly too hard. While obviously taking into account that really steep hills, you've got to go right down first. Last year, when I was in North Devon with my bike, I cycled over the border into Cornwall, along the coast to Bude, and there's a really impossible climb there. Just had to walk it. A bit like a couple of the climbs out of Widdicombe in the moor on Dartmoor. Though by now I have actually found the best climb out of Widdicombe. I mean, it's steep, but not as steep as the other climbs. Past Knutsworthy Farm. Steeper than this climb. Respite now. Tell you what, Nidderdale has been taken over by Himalayan balsam. That's not it. You can always tell it because it smells sickly sweet. Not it either, which is good. That is it, over there on the right. And that is it on the left. Like the cuckoo in the nest of plants, non-native species, and look at it, this is everywhere. It bullies its way into the hedgerows. And the quicker people bash it down, the quicker it comes back. I've really noticed it this summer while cycling in Nidderdale. That's not it. Neither is that. Different flower, similar, same colour, but different flower, different stalk, different leaves. To the balsam. Still we climb. I'm not there yet. I confess I've gone down to first gear. Oh, look at all that Himalayan balsa. God, it's a nightmare. It's a bit more to go. Gosh, berries on the tree already. It's only the beginning of August. I can see Brimham Rocks over there. Yes. There's a bit more to go. And cycling past Brimham Rocks is relatively easy going. And then there's a downhill stretch before a sharpish, shortish climb back to Burnt Yates, where we started. We've done 20 and a half miles. This Himalayan balsam can grow to about 12 foot high. Can you believe it? I shouldn't really pull it up by the roots when it's in flower, because the seeds grow everywhere, and guess what? It grows again. And they also fly off in the wind to new locations. Takes over from our existing plants. Not far to go. Brimham Rocks over there and there. Hopefully it gets a bit easier. Oh. And I think we're just coming up to the junction. Yes. Change up now. Ooh. Left here. Good view ahead. Some sort of monument or something on top of that hill. It's probably just a phone mast. Come on, off we go. Whee! Down to Brimham Rocks. Which are ahead? They're starting to come out. Oh, a little bit. Maybe it's just my sunglasses. They do get heather up here. Oh, we are high up. Views across North Yorkshire. pulling the wrong chain ring. Never mind. Tell you what, this is so different from where I was near York day before yesterday, isn't it? And the Yorkshire Wilds. It's a unique thing about Yorkshire. So much choice, different terrains. You're not stuck with the same old like you are in most counties. Yeah, that's heather. There is heather coming out. Very soon it's going to be a downhill section. Hello. Takes some doing, cycling with all that. It's probably doing the way of the roses. Now this is where we leave the Way of the Roses. It goes right to Pateley Bridge. Cycling with that gear is not going to be easy. And she's just come through the Yorkshire Dales. Ooh. At least you have that nice downhill section that we just climbed up to Brimham Rocks and then all the way down to Ripon. Basically much of the way we just come. Still, we have it, Finlay and Bolson. Oh God, I hate this stuff. Not that though, that's not, that is, that's not. Thank you. the final climb coming up. It's not a, I don't think it's a bad one. My old eye off the ball there. Remember the rule, 18 inches from the curb. One of the first rules of cycling. I think that's us done with the hills now. With the climbs, rather. Ooh. Thank you. not too far to go before we're back at Burnt Yates, where we began. We join the main Pateley Bridge Road soon. Here's where we join the Pateley Bridge Road, and it takes us straight into Burnt Yates. At 26 miles, slightly over. Here we are, Burnt Yates. There's a free car park here, by the way, which is where I've parked. My car park's on the left. So anyway, thank you for watching again, and I'll catch up with you next time.